two, one.
Cordial relations continue to thrive as the two economies of joint ventures in the socio-economic spheres, notably the water weed project, in which Egypt injected over $30 million to deal with the water weed on the waters of Lake Victoria, Choga, Albert, among others. The Cairo government also injected good money in the construction of valley dams across the country, and these are being constructed in the districts of Liantonde, Soroti, Oyam, among others. On his official visit to Uganda, the Egyptian Minister for Water Resources and Irrigation commissioned some of these projects. The minister reached Jinja, where he visited the Egyptian hospital in Jinja, a state-of-art facility fully equipped with modern medical equipment.
Planning to continue this because it is very important for Ugandan people, so we are keen to complete it and also continue with it.
Okay.
Here you have abundance of water, but you suffer from water scarcity. How come is that? Because of water management. In Egypt, we are a dry country. We don't have enough water to serve our needs. So we recycle, sewage water, toilet water. We treat it and reuse it again four times.
Honorable Muhammad Abdel Ati said that amidst the circulation of negative propaganda on the bilateral relations between Kampala and Cairo, Egypt is committed to strengthen more of the relations by encouraging many of the investors to Uganda and also investing in a series of projects as it has always been. The minister hinted on many other projects that are funded by his government in Uganda.
We need to support, the physical water scarcity by having bilateral projects, by having more ties in terms of cultivating what we need here. And this will happen actually after we develop the corridor, the development corridor, that will link physically our nations together. We are open, whatever project Uganda would think to build, we are ready to support and cooperate and look for means for financing this project.
Speaking about the water weed project that's phasing out soon, he disclosed that the executive in Cairo is ready to persuade parliament to renew the project as it has been so beneficial to Uganda's economy. He further stressed that Egypt shall continue investing in water management projects in the country.
Egyptian communities here, we encourage you to come and invest in Uganda because Uganda is very promising country. But on the other side, the message also for both nations that we have to be cautious of those who are putting poison to our relation, trying to poison our relation and create rumors like colonial agreements. In fact, all our cooperation under these colonial agreements. So what is bad about colonial agreements as far as we are cooperating, building project together, we have very stable relations and we have to strengthen them.
Men in Uganda have now some hope. Looking at these machines, mammogram, and when you look at these machines of CT scan, and they are powerful machines here. And I think our people, they have been here for only 3 to 4 months. And I think our people who do not know should get to know this and have these services.
The State Minister for Fisheries, Helen Andoa, commended the cordial relations between the two countries, thereby committing on behalf of Uganda. Story by Ivan Lubega for the news.